new topic from grade 7th English, and in today's lecture we are going to start a new topic, that is punctuation. So this is a very minute yet very important topic of your grammar. See, whenever we are writing something and we are speaking something, there is a difference. Suppose I am talking right now and I talk like this. I talk like in the manner that you have to note down your things and do it very properly. You have to do it in a one go, and you have to do it. You have to maintain your notebook. You have to maintain your book. You have to carry your pencil box. You have to carry your books. You have to carry your notebooks. You have to carry your bag. You have to carry your tiffin box. So you understood anything? No. So what is important here when you are talking? When you I have written, see, you are supposed to do the work by Monday. Send all the pictures, files and all related work. See, here I have not put a full stop. So you are reading in continuation. You are supposed to do the work by Monday. Send all the. So if a full stop will come here, then you will take a pause. So this is what punctuation does. It provides pauses in your written script. And while you are speaking also, when you are speaking, you are aware that where to take a pause. But while you are writing, if these punctuation marks here also pictures, comma, files, so that you take a pause. So these punctuation marks are very, very, very important in your grammar. These are very simple things, but yet it holds a very important part in the grammar. If you are writing anything and the punctuation marks are not there, it is also very incorrect. So in today's lecture we are going to read all the punctuation marks like colon, semicolon. You must be not knowing much about them. In today's lecture we will make our doubts clear and we will read punctuation.
Okay, so now we are going to start punctuation from the book. This chapter is not that long, it is not that confusing, but it has some small points which are very important, like different punctuation marks are there which we are going to study in depth. Punctuation means the correct use of putting the pauses or stops in writing to present the clear meaning of a sentence. As I have explained you already that you use punctuation marks to take pauses so that a sentence breaks down in correct order and it doesn't sound odd. Following are some important punctuation marks. So we are going to read some of the punctuation marks. First of them being the most important and the most common, the full stop. The full stop shows the largest pause. Okay, so it shows the largest pause. When you put a full stop, you take the longest pause. It is used in the following ways: at the end of an assertive, affirmative, negative or imperative sentence. Means when you are commanding, when you are requesting, when you are ordering something, or when you are saying a general statement in either positive or negative sense, then the use of full stop is required. See, Sonali works hard. So here the sentence is being completed. Therefore, we need to end it. And how we will end it? We will end it by putting a full stop. Meenal does not cry. So here also a negative sentence. Fourth one, see, don't make a noise. okay? Here you are commanding someone, don't make a noise. Obey your parents. Again, you are making a order. So you end the sentence with a full stop to show that your statement is over. After abbreviation for degrees and titles, example. So after abbreviation also we put full stops. Like after a name, when we are using it as an abbreviation, suppose someone's name is Bankim Nath Ray, so he doesn't write full name, he writes B.N.Ray. For the degrees, M.Com, Master of Commerce, so a full stop is put before the com, and afterwards C, the MSc, Masters in Science, so M, then dot, then SC. SC is the abbreviation for science. PhD, okay, philosophical doctorate, doctor, mister, like that we use full stops after these. In current English language, full stop is optional, means you have to decide that where to use it or where to not. Now, some capital letters are there where we have to use the full stop. Okay, no, sorry. Capital letters are also a part of punctuation. How? If we don't use the capital letter, then your marks and your marks get deducted in your exams, and it is grammatically incorrect. Capital letter is used for the following purposes. At the beginning of a sentence, okay, she is a good student. So S will be capital. The God created men. Other than that, the first letter of a proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Proper noun, you all know. Chitra knows me. So C will be capital. Prerna teaches me maths. So P will be capital. To begin the first letter of the word of every line of a poem. In poem also, every line of the poem, it begins with the capital letter. For some of the names of institutions like DPS Haldwani Lama Chowk, so D will be capital. Amrapali, A will be capital. To bring the names of days, the week and months, okay, Saturday, February, June, like this, it will be in capital letter. It will begin with capital letter. To begin the names of religions like Hinduism, Sikhism, Islam, Christianity, all this will begin with capital letter. For the name of epics and journals, for the name of books like the Holy Quran, the Bhagavad Gita, it will begin with, first of all, it will have the in front of them and it will begin with capital letter. For the names of festivals, Eid, Guru Parv, like this. So this all you can read from your book. Now, the question mark. The question mark is used after WH question and direct questions. What are you playing? WH questions are how, what, when, where. Had they left their school? See, here WH is not there, but still it is a question, so we will put a question mark. Are you okay? Then we will put a question mark. Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark is used after interjections. It is used after exclamation showing grief, joy, surprise, etc. What a beautiful scenery it is. You are mesmerized by the beauty, so you will put a exclamation mark. Alas, his dog died. Alas is used to show your grief. The comma is very important one. It is not like full stop. It doesn't has a long pause, but a shorter one. The shortest pause. To mark off a direct quotation. Stop writing. Okay. The teacher said, so you are quoting someone, so you will put a comma before the. To separate two or more words, like Anant is smart, wise, honest, and hopeful. So there are different qualities of Anant. We will put a comma. I think this is clear to each one of you. Okay. Need not to go into the depth. You can read the comma from the book. The semicolon. Now, it is now important. The semicolon denotes a greater pause than a comma. It is used for the following. Okay, semicolon is a different thing. It has one full stop and downwards it has a comma. Now see how it is used. To separate the parts of a sentence. Madan started to do overtime for he wanted money to make his own house. To separate the pairs of words. Accept, accept, sale, sale. Like this you do. Sale, then comma, then sale, then semicolon. If you are writing pairs of words. The colon. The colon represent a still longer pause. It is used to denote a quotation. Teacher. Rome was not built in a day. So we are like a script is there. Teacher, the dialogues are written like this. God made the man. Man made the nation. So we are separating the two things. The hyphen. Hyphen is a dash. We call it a dash. A small point like a dash. The hyphen is the half length of a dash. It is not a complete dash. Dash is different. The hyphen is the half dash. It is used between compound words like my sister-in-law. You don't write sister-in-law full. Brother-in-law, you don't write it without any hyphen. You have to use the hyphen from next time. You have to be quite clear about it. Quotation mark. Like we were doing in the earlier one, in the comma one, we were using it when we are quoting someone. So we have to use the quotation mark. The apostrophe. Apostrophe, it is used before S. We say apostrophe S. Okay. Book. Rams. Shams. Teachers. Students. Like this. To show possession, to denote time and distance. Amit's bag, Neha's teacher, Ram's cat, like this. Okay. Now we have the dash. The dash is a longer pause than a hyphen. It is used for the following. It is used after a list. Okay. Follow the names of items given below. Okay. So you are mentioning few things, so you put a dash to show a break in the sentence. There are two parts of a sentence, then dash, subject and predicate. Now quickly we will see some exercises. I think most of it is clear to you. Now we will just move for the exercises. Exercise A you have to do on your own. B I am explaining you. Punctuate the following sentences using capital letters wherever necessary. See, Mr. Sandeep. So M will be capital, S will be capital, and dot will be there. Got the MSc. M will be capital, then dot, then SC. Degree from the Delhi. Delhi mein D will be capital. University U will be capital this year. God is great. G will be capital in the second sentence. He has showered on us heavenly blessings. Okay. Then full stop will be there. In the first sentence also, in the last, full stop will be there. I wrote the story of the ant and the grasshopper. So, I will be capital first of all. And then at the last, full stop will be there. The festival of Holi. So, T will be capital, H will be capital. Was celebrated last month. So full stop will be there. So I think it is clear to you how to do the exercise. It is very easy and I hope that you will do it very carefully. Exercise A, you have to read and you have to do on your own.
Okay, class. So, today we did punctuation and I hope that all your doubts regarding the topic are clear and you know where to use which mark, where to use the punctuation marks in the right order. So, I wish that you will complete all the work and I know that you will do it. Do the work with a pencil in your grammar book as I have told you in the video, in the lecture, and complete all the work. We will meet again soon with one new lecture of your grammar. So till that time, take care of yourself, complete all the pending work, and we will meet again soon.